Welcome to the new Key Mortgage Marketing Services website. Our job in marketing services is to help our loan officers succeed, and we hope this video helps you do just that. Our in-depth video will go through a variety of topics to help you get the most out of the marketing services site, including our newly designed homepage, creating a brochure, creating a postcard, purchasing a mailing list, and uploading a mailing list. To start, you will need your credentials to log in to the Key Mortgage website. You can access the site either by utilizing our Google Single Sign-On function or by typing in your username, which is your Key Mortgage email, and your password. For this tutorial, I will be utilizing Leslie's Key Mortgage account. Once you have successfully logged in to the Key Mortgage website, you'll be brought to our homepage. We've revamped our homepage so that our newly updated search feature is your focal point when accessing the site. You'll be able to type in search terms like co-brand, bio, or business card, and your screen will populate all of the templates that correspond to your search term. To go a step further, we've added template filtering to aid in your search as well. We knew it could be overwhelming searching for a specific brochure or business card template and then needing to scroll through all of those options in front of you. Now, after you search for brochures, you can use the filters visible on the left-hand side of your screen to narrow down your search even further. So if you're trying to find property brochures and you've already searched for brochures, just click the checkbox for property under our type filter. It's that simple. In the past, if you were hard at work on a template or a mailing list and accidentally clicked on the delete button, it was gone forever. Now, when you're working quickly and accidentally delete something in your cart, just simply head over to your headshot and click to locate the trash function. Find that important mailing list or template and simply undelete it to bring it back to life. Let's get started with creating a brochure. Once the template of your choice has been selected, you'll input the property information one of two ways. You can either select the property by searching by the MLS number, which will automatically feed through the property info, or you are able to utilize our Create a Name field, or as we like to call it, our Draft feature, that allows you to manually add in all of the necessary information for the property. For this example, we'll use the Create a Name feature. I'll start by naming my template the property address for easy searching if I need to place a reorder. Once I've typed in the name, I'll select the Next button. From here, we've made it to step two, photo selection. In this step, I'm going to upload all of the property images that I have available. Once all images have been uploaded, I'm able to continue on to photo selection. You're able to pick and choose your desired images that you want available for selection within the template. Once your images feature check marks on them, that's your way to know they'll be ready to use in your template. I've selected all of my necessary images, so I will click Finished. This brings me to step three, Create Template. On this screen, you're able to click into all editable fields to customize your brochure selection by placing your property images, adding text, and so on. After your brochure has been created, all fields are filled out, and you're ready to order, you can click on the Add to Cart button on your screen. This will bring you to our Edit Output Shipping screen, where you can enter in the desired quantity you would like to order and where they should be shipped to. Once you enter your shipping information, you'll be brought back to your shopping cart to complete your order. It's important to note that if you have other materials that aren't yet ready to be checked out, you will have to move them to your save for later to move forward with your order. The last step that needs to be completed is our approval process. This step is here to confirm that you've reviewed your order, all information and images are correct, and you approve the file to be printed. To do this, all you need to do is click on the Approve text underneath your template in your cart, review the pop-up on the screen, and click Approve if you've reviewed your order. Now you'll notice the checkout button is no longer grayed out. All that is left to do is enter any necessary billing information and complete your order. Creating a postcard is pretty similar to our brochure creation process. You'll peruse through our postcard template options until you've filtered through and found your perfect postcard template. Click the Select button to add it to your cart, create a name for your template, and get to editing all of the necessary fields. For this example, I've selected an I've Moved postcard from our site and edited it as needed. You're able to add contact information, your NMLS number, some body copy, and an image to this postcard pack. Once I've got that to my liking, I can proceed with adding the template to my cart and completing the edit output options. In order to purchase a mailing list for your postcard, you will select the Use a Mailing List field in the shipping options. From here, you'll click on Purchase List. The first step is to name it something that will help you to differentiate your list from one another, either the name of your sphere or the name of your mailer. After you've named it, you're able to use our tool to narrow down your sphere of influence, starting with targeting individuals. From here, you can choose to search by geography or demography. For this example, we'll use our geography feature. You'll want to pick either the address of the home or a central location to base your mailing off of. After the address has been entered and the map has pinpointed the location, you'll proceed by either increasing or decreasing the radius around the address. This can go as small as 0.2 miles to narrow down the addresses available, or you can widen your search as well to choose from a larger variety of addresses. Once you're happy with your radius, you can preview the list to ensure that all is correct and then complete your purchase. Once the purchase is complete, it will bring you to the mailing list screen where you will review your purchase list. You'll want to select the Back to Shipping Cart Options button at the top to apply your list to the order, then enter any necessary billing information and complete your order. If you already have a mailing list you'd prefer to use, uploading it is so easy. Starting in the same shipping screen, under the Use a Mailing List section, you will instead select the Create and Import New List button. The first step is to name your mailing list that you'll be uploading and select the Submit button. You'll now be brought to our Import Mailing List screen, where you'll see our instructions and requirements for your upload. We have a sample template if you're a visual person who can benefit from a pre-filled template to work with, or you're able to view our list of acceptable column names to ensure all information uploads correctly to the site. To upload your .xlsx file, click on the Select File button and locate your mailing list. Click the Upload button and wait for your confirmation that the list has been successfully uploaded. You'll see the bar turn green and inform you the number of contacts has been imported. This is when you know it's worked correctly. To review your uploaded list, you can select on the Back to List button that will show you the contents of your mailing list. You'll then want to select Back to Shipping Cart Options at the top to apply your list to the order and complete the checkout process. Thank you for watching. We hope you found this video helpful and learned some tips and tricks along the way. Please remember, if you are hard at work creating your marketing materials on the site and you have some questions or you need our help, we're here for you. We work Monday through Friday, 8:30 to 5 p.m., and during that time, you can call or email us with questions or concerns. We'd love to hear from you.